Stretch, stretch with me, hands in the air. Count to three, hold it right there. Stretch up high for a snack in the trees. Stretch out wide for a ride on the breeze. Can you stretch to the ceiling? Can you stretch to the floor? You can stretch with a whisper. You can stretch with a roar. I can stretch underwater. I can stretch on a wave. I can stretch on a surfboard if I'm very, very brave. Some will stretch to show you feathers. Some will stretch to show you spots. A stretch that goes a stretch too far might tie you up in knots. A yawn is just a stretch that starts down deep inside. It travels up into your mouth and makes it open wide. If I were an inchworm, I'd stretch from place to place. If I were an astronaut, I'd stretch in outer space. I stretch my lungs to take a breath, then blow out nice and slow. A bubble will stretch and stretch until there's no room left to grow. Pop! If you stretch me and I stretch you, we'll stretch twice as far. Who knows what we can do? The end.
Okay, so that was our stretch. And now we're going to do a little wiggly. Do you have wiggles in you? I have wiggles in me. So let's do that one as well. Let's do the wiggle.
Wiggle. Do you wake up with a wiggle? Do you wiggle out of bed? If you wiggle with your breakfast, it might wind up on your head. First, wiggle where your tail would be. Then, wiggle all your hair. Feeling extra silly? Wiggle in your underwear. Can you wiggle with your shadow? Can you wiggle with your toys? When you wiggle with gorillas, do they make a wiggle noise? Can you wiggle in the water? Wiggle one fin on each side. Or wiggle like a crocodile, open big and wide. When you wiggle where your wings would be, wiggles fill the sky. Wiggle slowly when with polar bears. They're very wiggle shy. Snakes are one big wiggle. No wings, no tails, no feet. Some wiggles are worth waiting for. Wiggle, wiggle, tweet! Would you join me for a wiggle? Would you wiggle on the moon? I think we're out of wiggles now. See you wiggle soon. The end.
Okay, so did you get your wiggles out? Did you get some of your muscles moving? Now, we're going to enjoy another thing. We're going to enjoy a story. It's called
Welcome to the wonderful world of reading. In this I Can Read story, Pete the Cat, Pete at the Beach, you will be going on a fun adventure. Are you ready to read? Here we go.
Whatever he does, you do, okay? I'll do it too.
It is a hot day. Pete the Cat goes to the beach with his mom and his brother, Bob. Let's go in the water, Bob says. Maybe later, says Pete. Bob likes to surf. He rides the big waves. It looks like fun. I'm hot, says Pete. Go in the water, says Mom. Maybe later, says Pete. Pete makes a sandcastle. His mom helps him dig. Here comes a big wave, and there goes Pete. Oh no! Where did his sandcastle go? Bob rides a big wave. Wow, says Pete. That looks like fun. Pete and his mom take a walk. They find seashells. They see a crab. Pete's feet get wet. His feet feel cool. The rest of him is hot. It is time for lunch. Pete eats a sandwich. He drinks lemonade. The sun is very hot. And Pete is very, very hot. Bob is wet and cool. Let's play ball, says Pete. No thanks, says Bob. I want to surf. Pete throws the ball. His mom catches it. Let's get our feet wet, says Mom. Well, okay, says Pete. The water is cool. It feels good. Pete goes in deeper. Bob waves to Pete. I want to show you how to surf, he yells. Pete does not say, maybe later. He says, let's do it. Lie on the board, says Bob. Pete lies on the board. Paddle, says Bob. Pete paddles out. He waits for a big wave. A big wave is coming. Stand up, says Bob. Pete stands up. Then Pete falls down. It was scary, but it did not hurt. Try again later, says Bob. Pete wants to try again now. Pete lies down again. He paddles out and waits. Here comes a wave. Pete stands up. This time, he rides the wave. Good job, says Bob. Pete wants to surf all day. Bob does too. So they take turns. Pete and Bob rock and roll with the waves. What a great day! It is okay to be afraid, but it is more fun to surf. It is a hot day. Pete the Cat goes to the beach with his mom and his brother, Bob. Let's go in the water, Bob says. Maybe later, says Pete. Bob likes to surf. He rides the big waves. It looks like fun. I'm hot, says Pete. Go in the water, says Mom. Maybe later, says Pete. Pete makes a sandcastle. His mom helps him dig. Here comes a big wave. And there goes Pete. Oh no! Where did his sandcastle go? Bob rides a big wave. Wow, says Pete. That looks like fun. Pete and his mom take a walk. They find seashells. They see a crab. Pete's feet get wet. His feet feel cool. The rest of him is hot. It is time for lunch. Pete eats a sandwich. He drinks lemonade. The sun is very hot. And Pete is very, very hot. Bob is wet and cool. Let's play ball, says Pete. No thanks, says Bob. I want to surf. Pete throws the ball. His mom catches it. Let's get our feet wet, says Mom. Well, okay, says Pete. The water is cool. It feels good. Pete goes in deeper. Bob waves to Pete. I want to show you how to surf, he yells. Pete does not say, maybe later. He says, let's do it. Lie on the board, says Bob. Pete lies on the board. Paddle, says Bob. Pete paddles out. He waits for a big wave. A big wave is coming. Stand up, says Bob. Pete stands up. Then Pete falls down. It was scary, but it did not hurt. Try again later, says Bob. Pete wants to try again now. Pete lies down again. He paddles out and waits. Here comes a wave. Pete stands up. This time, he rides the wave. Good job, says Bob. Pete wants to surf all day. Bob does too. So they take turns. Pete and Bob rock and roll with the waves. What a great day! It is okay to be afraid, but it is more fun to surf.
So, I hope you like that story. His friend asked him if he wanted to go in the water. And then when the mom said to go in the water earlier, Pete originally says, maybe later. Do you think he was maybe scared a little bit? And then what happened next?
Welcome to the wonderful world of reading. In this I Can Read story,
so